Roskills, welcome back to the Roskills channel. This is the ultimate football show where we talk about everything and anything I want to talk about. Donny van de Beek to Man United. This is a player that I've been following and tracking for the last 3 years, man. I've been watching Ajax and especially the Dutch national team, watching him there with Ronald Koeman in that little total football replica system. I think van de Beek is a very great player. I think he's amazing. I think he would work at United, but it's a very nonsensical signing, especially with the fact that they have Bruno Fernandes. For me, van de Beek is just a more polished version of Bruno Fernandes. He's probably better than Bruno Fernandes, which is why it's so weird to me, because you have two players that play the same position just in completely different ways. Bruno Fernandes wants to get shots off. Van de Beek is a more cultured CDM. He stays in between the lines, gets the ball, makes runs beyond the striker. That's his style of play. One thing I love about him, I wanted him at Bayern Munich, my club, was that, you know, he just likes to keep the ball. I really did want him. He likes to keep the ball, especially in between the lines. That's something that Bruno Fernandes doesn't really seem to want to do. He always tries to get the ball and make this magical pass over the top between the that. He tries it a lot. He loses a lot of the ball. So van de Beek, for me, is just a more polished version of Bruno Fernandes. But I don't know why. I don't get the signing. Because first of all, he can play as a number six, but that's not his position. He wants to get forward and score goals. He has more goals than assists for a reason. That's why they're buying him. The goals and the assist. His creativity is good. He can definitely shoot from both feet and pass with both feet. He can spray a pass if he needs to. But that's not his best position. We all know that. I don't even think he can play like an advanced number, you know, like a number eight, where a box to box. I'm not so sure. I mean, football's moving away from the dominant big old CDM standing in front of the back four. We're moving away from that. We're going towards double pivots, you know, technical and press resistant midfielders and ball playing CDMs like Kimmich. We're moving towards that now. Casemiro, look at him versus City. He got pressed down like a remote controller. And you could really tell he was lacking in terms of his ball creative skills. But seriously, man, van de Beek to United makes no sense to me. I mean, not that he's a terrible player. I love him. He's a great player. It's just the timing of it. First of all, United, for me, need a left back before they need another attacking midfielder. That's probably the thing. And also, they probably need a better manager, because I checked a few stats and I checked a few things and I watch United games. Whenever Bruno Fernandes goes off, and actually, if Paul Pogba's off and Bruno Fernandes is still playing, the system is completely different without those two. It's completely different. Are you going to tell me that Fred, who was at Shakhtar Donetsk and was probably one of the best passers in between the lines and breaking the lines in the Champions League, can't break the lines? Because I'm noticing that Paul Pogba really is the one breaking the lines whenever he plays. But then when Fred plays ahead of Pogba or next to Pogba, Bruno Fernandes is never picking up the ball from Fred in the exact same positions he would be from Pogba. That's coaching, okay? That's the coach telling him to be in certain positions. And you shouldn't really change that if... Nah, man. This is too much thinking, man. I just think Solskjaer is completely overrated. I think, he's been 10 years in the management game. Still don't know what he plans to do with his tactics. I think he'll get exposed in the big stage. He'll get exposed at the Camp Nou. Actually, no. No one gets exposed there nowadays. No, Leganés could go there and slap up Barcelona. He'll get exposed, in my opinion. Those, you know, European games. Look at Sevilla, for example. People keep telling me, George, Man United got unlucky with the chances. Sevilla popped them around. Both goals that Sevilla scored were both just tactical goals. We all know Sevilla tried to sucker their opponent to one side and then try and cross it to the other side and try and isolate the fullbacks and the center backs in the center with a striker. Both goals they scored were exactly that same style. So for me, you know, that's coaching. That's coaching. That's Sevilla beat United with coaching, not with defensive errors, not with finish. I mean, what did you expect their goalkeeper to not save shots? And some of the shots you can blame on the strikers, but for me, Man United didn't go into that game with a "we're United, we're gonna take on." Sevilla had more of the ball, I think, and it's just really interesting. I think he's a very good player, van de Beek, but the profile and the style doesn't make sense to me. That's really something that you have to point out in United's team. because they are, I guess, a counter-attacking team, not really a possession team. They're not a Pep Guardiola team. They're not moving the ball at 3 billion miles per hour in between the lines. They're not Bayern Munich, where we pack up the half spaces and try and move the ball higher up the pitch with Alaba progressing it. Harry Maguire is not really that great of a ball progressor into the final third. He doesn't really break the lines. Usually, he breaks his legs trying to pass the ball and make these impossible passes. So, with United being a counter-attacking team, I don't understand the Van de Beek signing because he's not a counter-attacking player. He's Ajax, total football. Right? That's what they learn. They learn to play different positions and to keep the ball, and that's the most important thing for them. So if United had someone like a Erik ten Hag, who I really would like at a bigger club, because that's a manager I really rate, if he had Van de Beek on his hands and he could pick, I think United would have something big there. Solskjaer could take you to that. He hugs players, calls them nicknames, but is he the world-class top? No. I would love to see Manchester United versus a team like Leipzig, because Leipzig would absolutely blow you out of the water with their tactical movement. And I'd love to see Bayern, not just a Bayern fan, Bayern versus Man United. Even if we lose, okay, I think we could absolutely clatter them tactically. And that's something that United don't have. You don't have that. You don't have, ooh, movement. Oh, Müller's here. Lewandowski moves. And then you don't have this fluidity. You don't have that. It very much seems like it's individualistic. And that's something that I've noticed at Man United that I'll keep saying, okay? So Van de Beek going to United makes sense. As he's a great player, but not for the system or the position that I think he'll be playing. Honestly, I see him playing that Pogba position where I guess he's supposed to be the ball carrier. I don't know. That's a waste. You don't waste a player and not play them in their best position. Unless Solskjaer wants to go with two attacking 10s or attacking number 8s with a 4-3-3. I don't know where Pogba would be, but or 4-4-3. Because Van de Beek has to start. First, he's better than Bruno Fernandes for me. Like, yes, this is a player that I wanted at Bayern. So, of course, he's better than... yeah, he's good. Very, very, very good. I didn't want him at Bayern recently, right? I wanted him at Bayern when we were linked to Erik ten Hag. We're not linked to Erik ten Hag, so I never wanted Van de Beek up until this point because Thomas Müller came back to himself. But Van de Beek, for me, makes zero sense for United. I think if they want something or someone to come in, he should have been in a defensive midfielder. You can go in and find a good, competent defensive midfielder for 20 million. I could buy you. United don't even need Sancho. I keep saying it. They're so obsessed with this Sancho. Sancho's going to take us. You don't need Sancho as much as you think you do. In my opinion, look at Ferran Torres going to Man City. You know, Ferran Torres in the right system, which he is going into at Man City, will pull up with astronomical numbers. But that's just my opinion. Thank you everyone so much for watching. I'm out. Raw Skills.